MHS came together to support some amazing athletes. Key Club stepped it up for the Walk for Water. And we bring you the latest updates on the construction of the new MHS. This is MET News. Welcome to this episode of MET News. I'm your host, Chris Kogan. Let's get right to the lead. On Friday, May 3rd, students of MHS filled the gymnasium bleachers to participate in the 2019 Special Olympics send-off pep rally, where they heard speeches from all the participants. Let's take a look at the news story produced by Katie Benson and Eden Eugenio.
I'm here in the gymnasium where we're about to embark on the 2019 Special Olympics pep rally. Here we will hear speeches from all the Special Olympics athletes. Let's take a look. No limits she craves, attention she praises, an image she prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see.
For those of you who don't know, Best Buddies is the world's largest organization dedicated to ending the social, physical, and economic isolation of the 200 million people with intellectual and developmental disabilities.
My favorite part of the Special Olympics pep rally is getting to see all the athletes and how happy they are when they're in the center of the court. The whole gym is cheering them on and just that smile on their faces.
I look around during pep rally sometimes and just see big smiles on people's faces.
This pep rally is special to me because growing up, like some of my friends, like Cindy Montross, her brother Adam, like he's one of the athletes. And so getting to see the impact that it's had on not only the athletes, but seeing the impact on their families as well, it's just so heartwarming.
Hello, my name is Adam Montross. I am running the 200 meter dash and the 400 meter dash. I am also competing in the long jump. Thanks for the MHS band for the great music today. Go team.
I feel like it's a good way to show like unity of the team and the town, and it brings people together as a whole.
We've been doing this event for Special Olympics since 1999, and every year it gets better and better and bigger, and that this event has become a model all throughout the country of exactly how you can bring a community together to show what inclusion and acceptance and what a unified school really and truly means.
Special Olympians from all different grades got the chance to be together and have a well-remembered date at the MHS pep rally. Here's a highlight produced by Courtney Roberts.
My favorite thing about Marchi is I like to be cheered on.
My face above the water, and my feet can't touch the ground, and it feels right. I can see the sands on the horizon every time.
Competing in the 25 meter wheelchair race and tennis ball throw.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
and to make sure the fact that every single student feels they have a home here. And your applause today, from all of you sitting in this audience, you were amazing today. And when you need a school to rise to an occasion and to just know that we are a strong school, it's these are the moments right here. I couldn't be prouder of you. I could not be prouder to be your principal.
The softball team has won four straight games before facing off against Hull on Monday, May 6th. The girls walked away with a 14-0 win to get their eighth win of the season. They later went on to face Mashpee on Thursday, May 9th. The team will play against Brockton on May 10th, Sandwich on May 13th, and at Norwell on Wednesday, May 15th. Baseball played at Hull on Monday, May 6th. The game was a swinging success with Middleborough coming out on top with a 10-1 win. The team's record is 6-3 going into their game at Mashpee on Thursday, May 9th. There's a string of home games coming up in the next few days with the team getting ready to play Cohasset on the 13th and Norwell on the 15th. The boys' tennis team had a 4-1 win against Mashpee on Monday, May 6th. Junior captain and first singles player Declan Hastings was 6-1 at first singles before losing his second match of the year against a very talented Mashpee player. The rest of the squad cruised to an easy victory, resulting in the team's fifth win of the season. Following the win, they went on to play on Mashpee's home turf on Thursday, May 9th. The boys will be playing against Cohasset on Monday, May 13th, and then will have back-to-back games against Norwell. They will be away on Tuesday the 14th and home on Wednesday the 15th. Girls tennis had a match against Mashpee on Thursday, May 9th. They now go on to play at home versus Cohasset on Monday, May 13th, home against Norwell on the 14th, and they will be playing at Norwell on the 15th. Girls lacrosse played at Dennis Yarmouth Regional High School on May 6th and at Norwell on May 9th. They now have a streak of games starting on Friday, May 10th at South Shore Volk Tech and being followed with games on Monday, May 13th against Dennis Yarmouth Regional, Tuesday, May 14th against East Bridgewater, and Wednesday, May 15th at Rockland. The boys lacrosse team had a game at Old Colony Regional Volk Tech on Wednesday, May 8th and against Norwell on the 9th. On Monday, May 13th, they will play at Coyle Cassidy, at East Bridgewater on the 14th, and against Rockland on the 15th. The track team competed against Abington on Monday, May 6th. Both male and female teams dominated, adding two more checks to the win column. An overall great performance from both teams with significant PRs from athletes. With a South Shore League Championship right around the corner on May 16th, we wish the best of luck to all the athletes. Here is a highlight produced by Katie Benson of some of the memorable moments at the Abington meet. On Sunday, May 5th, the Key Club held their annual Walk for Water. Matt DeRoches and Kyle Maloney were there to capture the great event.
I'm here at Key Club's annual event, Walk for Water. Let's check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Well, the Walk for Water is an event that the Key Club is holding for its second year this year, and it is to raise a well in the Kingdom of East Swaziland so that people won't have to walk for water, in a sense, 10 miles there and 10 miles back. It just helps with health and also education. So, well, it's a really great event, and I'm really happy that we're able to do it, and hopefully we'll raise enough money to build a well this year.
Just to help with the Walk for Water, help them to everyone, and ensure everyone has water. And I think it's a great cause.
Well, living in the U.S., we tend to take for granted our free resources. So doing this event really helps me feel good about myself giving back to other countries in need. Yes, we're hoping that next year we'll finally get good weather so we can do a lot more outdoor activities, such as more games, and we can expand upon our event as a whole.
Mostly just having Whitehead getting wet several times and, like, yeah, getting wet, but it's fun.
What an awesome event. We hope to see everyone out there next year. This has been Kyle Maloney with MET News.
The senior class is on the verge of graduating, and surely the class of 2019 has a lot of mixed thoughts on the matter. Here's a news story produced by Gil Arujo.
I'm very excited for graduation because I've been waiting for this moment. 4 years, like, it's crazy. So I can't wait to go on with this life, have my own apartment, have my own place, you know, have fun, go to college, you know, it's gonna be a big adventure.
Yes, I'm very excited about graduating because I've been in this school for about 4 years and I'm kind of ready to move on.
I'm excited to graduate because I have no more motivation to do any schoolwork, but it's also because I'm going to college and I'm very excited for college.
I am super excited for graduation. I've been waiting for this since I walked in senior year, and I'm really excited for college. I have gone to a good college, LaSalle, saw my sweatshirt right here, really excited. It's going to be fun.
I'm going to be going to UMass Dartmouth to major in chemistry and then hopefully get a job after that.
Plans for the future are to go into sports management in college at LaSalle and work for the Revolution. That's a soccer team.
I plan to go into fashion merchandising and I'm going to work for some retail company, selling clothes, having a good time. Pretty excited to work in the fashion industry.
Well, I have mixed feelings about it. It's really cool to see all my work in one place, but at the same time, it seems a little much to be doing all this work for a piece of paper, but that's all right.
I'm super excited. I can't wait for what the future holds for me, and I'm just ready to shine.
It's like really hitting me, but at the same time, I'm also really glad that it's coming to an end, because now I get to move on to like adult Ashley life, so it's pretty sick.
It's kind of wild. Like, I'm just having flashbacks to everything I've done these past 4 years, and I really think that I'm prepared, you know? I feel ready to go to college and do these college things. I feel like I learned a lot here, but ready to move on.
The new MHS is really kicking into high gear with the construction work. The foundation is being poured around the perimeter of the new building, and the Red Barn has been scheduled to be taken down on Saturday, May 11th. The construction team has also fenced out the fields and started the process of the new stadium, which should be ready for next year's fall season. You can even check out the progress yourself online with our 24/7 live feed at middleboroughtv.com or on the Middleborough Public Schools website. Thank you for joining us for this episode of MET News, and be sure to tune in on Friday, May 17th for our next episode. I'm Chris Kogan. Have a great night.